Hello SRL fans and welcome to this review and news video. Last Saturday we were racing at Bahrain and it was the 10th round of our season 3, and let's have a look at some news and on the review of the race and the qualifying session. So let's jump in. First of all, a big thank you to all of our supporters and drivers throughout season 1 and 2 and 3. Our league had our second anniversary on Monday, and I would love to thank you all for this amazing time. We have grown a lot since Sandro Doulis has built up this league. So thank you a lot. It was a big pleasure racing in this league. We've got a new reserve driver for Mercedes. It's Louis Quinlan from England. He's going to be the reserve driver for the Mercedes podcast. So that's Mercedes, Force India and Williams. He will jump in if there's a seat open at these three teams. So let's have a look into the weekend. Killian Brady, our championship leader, took pole position in front of his teammate Francis McGinn. Then was the rookie Lewis Marshall in the Mercedes, Alex Benacerti, Nick van Gelder, Jesper Lampinen. And you can see further down the order, Jure Marusic got a qualifying ban for Baku. That's what, because he blocked Sandro Doulis' flying lap. He was going purple that moment. That's why Sandro only started from P9. So the start went off. Killian Brady was in the lead ahead of the new guy, Lewis Marshall, but there was some drama going into turn 3 because Lewis Marshall and the championship leader Killian Brady had a collision, and Killian Brady hit the barrier and was out of the race. That was a really big deal, not only for the race because he was leading, but also for the championship. But Codelda, who's second in the championship, unfortunately missed this race. But we had another retirement after that. René van der Stap crashed his car. Sandro Doulis and Nick van Gelder, once again, like in Belgium, had a great battle for P5. Sandro Doulis was able to win that battle against the Renault driver. Then we had some crashes between Nick van Gelder. Jan crashed at the same lap. Going into the third sector, so another retirement for the Dutchman. The race result: Francis McGinn won the race for McLaren. Then was our rookie Lewis Marshall, strong outing for him. Alex Benacerti in third. Fourth is Jesper. Sandro with a solid fifth place. Then it's Nick, Andrew, Jan Holm, and Cameron Weston Edwards, who also got a qualifying ban, like Yannick, for crashes in the race. So we've got three people not qualifying at Baku in 2 weeks' time. These are the championship standings. Killian Brady retired off the race, but of course, because Bart Codelda wasn't able to participate, the gap stays the same. Cameron Weston Edwards in fourth, then it's Sandro Doulis, same points as Alex Benacerti behind him. Then it's Andrew Heff, Sander, Nick Ferrix, who still retired. And then Dion Stahl completes the top 10. Further down the order, we can see in P18, the rookie Lewis Marshall finished second at Bahrain. The team standings: McLaren was able to build the gap up to Red Bull Racing. Then it's Ferrari in third, fourth the Sauber, who are still really strong. And if you look down the order, it's Mercedes in 10th place. That's a big surprise for the strong team. So I hope you guys had fun watching this review video. We will be back with racing at Baku next week on Saturday, so I will hope you will tune in. We will be live on YouTube like always. So yeah, see you then. Goodbye, guys. Yeah, see you then. Goodbye, guys. Yeah, see you then. Goodbye, guys.